We are privileged to have with us today two high-level officials, one from the ultimate parent body, FIFA, and the other from our immediate supervisory body, and that is the CONCACAF. And I'm sure David and his team will most doggedly adhere to what the plan sets out. I'd like now invite the CONCACAF manager for development in this particular part of the world, Mr. Salcedo, to say a few words. Please welcome him.
Thank you very much. I'm not much of a politician or a speaker. I'd rather be on the field. But I'd like to acknowledge the head table and protocol being observed. And that one I say also the name for Veron. I'm bringing you greetings from our new president, also Mr. Victor Mutagliani, and our new general secretary, Mr. Philippe Mocchio. We are seeing something so different today, and I really would like to congratulate both, of course, the TTFA and of the National Board, the lottery here, because this is a totally unprecedented situation that we have seen in CONCACAF. And I'm not going to speak about any other continents, but I've been involved with the game. Somebody told me that I came here about 40 years ago. No, I was only 10 years old at that time, so no. I mean, it was not 40 years ago. Maybe it was 20 years ago, but I feel very happy here in Trinidad and again in Port of Spain, because yes, I've been here maybe 12, 15 times, but tonight is very special. And very special, not only in behalf of CONCACAF, but in my behalf. You know, I've been the director of development for 4 years officially, but basically I've been, without really knowing and without getting paid, I've been doing this for 45 years. So, you know, to see something like what we are doing tonight, Marvin, is a tremendous opportunity. And they already addressed a few of the things that I wanted to tell you as to why the game in football is so great. Because yes, we're speaking about future national players, future big stars, yes, but how many? Do you realize, and of course we're not giving any prizes tonight, but you realize that only out of 300 million players, only, listen to this one, 0.02% are professional players. So what do we do with the rest? This is what is so important. Marvin already said it. It is a complete program. It's not only to make them better players or to go to the World Cups. Of course, well, we all want to go to the World Cups. But it is important of what we are doing right now. And I kind of feel bad because Trinidad and Tobago, they are ahead of CONCACAF. You know, that's something that I said to David and to Joanne. I said, you're jumping ahead of us already because we're beginning something already with the new programs that we are doing. We're beginning with grassroots and moving up to where you're going to be now. It is so important to produce good players. But as Marvin said, it is so important to produce good young people, boys and girls. And then they can choose whatever they want to be. Because what about, you know, only again, 0.02% make it, even less make it to national teams, and even less make it to World Cups. But it is something that is so important. So again, I want to congratulate both, of course, the Federation and the Lottery Commission to be part of this. Now, FIFA, CONCACAF are behind these programs. And of course, I'm not going to be speaking for on behalf of FIFA. Veron is going to do that, but I'm speaking on behalf of CONCACAF. We are totally, totally behind this program. I'm going to be back soon again. I spoke with Joanne, and we're going to be speaking more and so, because there are so many elements that CONCACAF can bring to the table also, not only with coaches, but also some exchange programs for some of these young players to go to other countries, Mexico, U.S., whatever. So all this exchange is going to be taking place. But again, someone has to get started. And this is what it's all about tonight. They told me $1 million, you know, I said, this is for the next 20 years? Because no one read about it, get into any news, no one has come up and said, this is for the youth. There was a gentleman that went one time to a Congress in one of our national associations, because he went to one of their football stadiums and saw the young people playing in something that you would never want to see young players or young people playing. So the next day, he went to the Congress. He went to the Congress and said to all the members of Congress, how can you do this to your youth? He didn't say to them, how can you do this to football, to your youth. So when we're speaking right now, yes, again, we want to go to the World Cups, but we are talking about your youth. You know, everything that we're talking about tonight is what is going to do with this money. Yes, we're going to produce better coaches, and I want to use the better, you know, better capacitated coaches. Parents are going to be involved. Teachers are going to be involved. So again, it's not only football. Football is only a vehicle. I learned this many years ago, and of course, I'm not going to get into my personal story because I will make you cry. But honestly, I'm very happy to be here, which I almost didn't make it. I didn't go into that tonight, but you know, I almost didn't make it because I was supposed to go back to Miami 7 o'clock this morning. So David said, no, go. Friday night is the event. So thank you for reminding me, and I'm here tonight. But again, I'd like to say thank you and see until later by telling you the way we see it in CONCACAF, the way I see it personally being here, is I can tell you that the future of football in Trinidad and Tobago is very bright. Thank you.